Penny Dreadful is a show that people really seem to have fallen in love with. Why do you think that is? What is it about the show overall that people love, do you think?
Well, I think it's got a unique flavour. I mean, I think there's no other show like it. And it has elements which have already been proved to be popular, the horror element and the sci-fi element almost. But I think it's also beautifully written. And I don't think you get that type of writing very often on the television. And John Logan, the supremo of the whole thing, has a deep knowledge of Victorian England, and it shows. I think it's a very classy piece of work.
Is it a period of time that interests you particularly, and was that part of what made you want to take on the role?
Well, funnily enough, it wasn't, but since doing the first season, I've actually been reading a lot of Victorian literature, actually. And of course, John uses all the horror genre of Victorian literature, you know, the Dorian Grays and the Frankensteins and whatever, as part of his series. But yes, it is a period of history I do find absolutely fascinating. Now, I've been reading a lot of Dickens, for instance, who doesn't come up in Penny Dreadful, but it's part of that same genre. Well, my character was a bit of a mystery to start with. He's an Egyptologist who works at the British Museum. I don't want to really give away too much, but in case people haven't seen the first two seasons, but he's not what he appears to be. In fact, that's the same of every single character in the series. But he's one of the very few nice people, actually. He's a good man, but he's a very, very camp Egyptologist on the surface. They're amazing. People like Rory Kinnear and Helen McCrory and Timothy Dalton and, you know, Josh Hartnett, David Green. Amazing. A lot of them I've known before on doing stage work. So some of them are old colleagues. So it's lovely. And then I have new people to meet, like Harry Treadaway. He's great. Yeah. Well, I believe they're starting filming very soon. So with any luck, sometime next year, I would hope.
What are you personally hoping for from that?
Well, I'm unfortunately busy doing theatre, so I won't be in it as much as I was during the second season, which is personally very disappointing for me. But what I've seen, and I obviously can't say anything about it, it's some very nice writing for me, so I'm happy.